And well, this used to be the Zuiderzee, the South Sea. Now it's called the IJsselmeer, because the river IJssel ends in it. English speaking people often pronounce it IJssel, IJsselmeer, IJssel Lake. But the proper way to pronounce it is IJssel. So it's a freshwater lake now. After the Afsla dike was finished in the 30s, the salt water became brackish and slowly fresh. And actually making a fish migration river in the Afsla dike now. I'd like to go there, but the bicycle path is closed and I've tried to get there by car. You can't see anything. Just some construction going on, but we'll have to wait for another year, I guess. People enjoying the water. A lot of boats out there. You can go to Friesland, you can go to Flevoland, which is the biggest piece of artificial land in the world. Built in the 50s. And the idea was to make all of this one big polder, and that's why it's called the Afsla dike. But the Afsla dike is actually a dam now, the enclosure dam, because there's water on two sides, and a dike has land on one side at least. But okay, we didn't change the name. Lovely park there, but I want to go the other way. Because there's some dike renovations going on there. Supposed to go this way. There's no exception for cyclists or mopeds, so I'm sorry. So I'll just use parking lot instead. So I'm going in the direction of Amsterdam, which is way too far to cycle to at the moment. I'd absolutely need two full batteries and then take it easy or take the train back. And I should start in here so I can go directly then. A lot of mosquitoes today. So there's already a lot of work done here. In those big ovals. Reinforcement, Markermeer dyken, Markermeer dykes for water safety. On a city beach. Yeah, and of course they're gonna make a bicycle connection and a walking connection all the way to Amsterdam. Okay. It's 33 kilometers. That's over 20 miles. Dike reinforcements. Some people say the metropolitan region of Amsterdam, MRA, uses the money of the different regions, and this is not a government body, it's something else. It's a collaboration of politicians and companies and, I don't know, rich people. And some people say Amsterdam is kind of stealing the money and the reinforcements maybe not necessary. Well, I don't know, I don't have an opinion. I'm just pointing it out. I'm gonna circle back now. I don't want to take the exact same route. That would be kind of boring. So I'm gonna figure out. Alkmaar is 22 kilometers. That sounds pretty good. I'll go to Alkmaar and then go back to Heerenvaart. That would be a different route. So another battery check. 13%. So now I'm supposed to go 30 kilometers an hour max.
Ja.
would actually be nice to pass the Central Station. Well, Central Station, it's the only station in Hoorn. Pretty nice one. You didn't see me. Pretty dangerous. It's been a while. I think it's this way. Yeah, an old wall with new doors. A lot of buildings hanging over this place. 1698. These buildings have been sinking into the ground for centuries. That's why they're so hanging over so much. Pretty cool. cool old bike shop. The harvest that way. Another battery check. So this is the marina. Also an old harbor. Well, I believe they still have an old ship there, or a replica or something, I don't know. Well, the old harbor building is a museum. Oh, there's it, there it is. That's the center of Faring Heritage. We have some old cannons here. All painted, of course. So yeah, I'm gonna find a nice spot to change the battery. This is actually quite nice as well. Maybe I'll look through this park. Is this an island? Maybe so. I don't know. It's not an island. Oh. Not supposed to go here by speed pedelec, but well, no harm, no foul, right? This is nice. I just take it slow. Pretty cool. Typical Dutch brown water. And it's just all full of mud. This is a weird bridge. I'm not gonna slide off, am I? Yeah. Oh my, my bare legs. This is a steam needle, a nabble. Is that a railway track? Yeah, to the left. Speed. Level up.
Yeah, that's better.
A nice little park for walking your dog. I just walk around. Kind of an island at least. I don't know if it really connects. It's multiple islands. So I'm back in some neighborhood now. I guess I just have to circle around clockwise and continue in the direction of Alkmaar. Hi. Tennis and padel club. Some playgrounds. Park 2.0. Okay, oh, yeah, I started on the bridge to the left there. Oi. Right. 3%. Yeah, so we're back. The GoPro said trying to repair file and it failed, so maybe I'm missing the last 10 minutes or something, I don't know. We'll see when we get back home. would be a shame. I missed the ride through the spark. But okay, nothing I can do now. We just have to wait and see. Let's go back to Alkmaar and then Heergewaard. Camera's running. To the right. Born to the right. Alkmaar should be to the left then. We are going to go exactly the same way back. That was another speed pedal light. They're still pretty rare, but not that rare. But I don't think there's 100,000 of them in the Netherlands yet. So, yeah. I'm getting the feeling we're being directed to the same long road, the N194, or the Bobeldijk. Pretty nice when I'm moving. The air is warm, but certainly colder than my body. But when I have to stop, it's excruciatingly hot, and I start sweating a lot. That's okay. We had a few nice days. Before that, most of August and July were awful. And I think the end of June and the beginning of July maybe also was about 30 degrees for a week. So yeah. Not really hot. In general, just a few days. So yeah, here we go, the N194. To the left of us, of course. So I'm just gonna have to make this ride more interesting by trying to pick another road. But we've crossed some water. It doesn't have that many bridges across it, so let me think. Do I want to go around that much? Maybe I should have taken the industrial area here. That much. Oh, it's green. Oh, this could be an option. Yeah, cool. Yeah. This is a little bit different. Some options here. Well, that looks like a big mess to go left. So many mosquitoes. Let me see. ...10 kilometers to Heerhugowaard. Yeah, that puts me right back on the N194. Alkmaar is the other way. That's... Oh, the Vijverhof. Yeah, I know where I am now. Half an hour. I have to go back on the road here. Ah. That's all. He probably didn't know that I'm supposed to ride on the road there. And here. There's a swimming pool on the indoor sporting arena. Chinese and a library to go back. This village is called the Gorn. Yeah, I'm going left to Kersin. Back to Spiedijk. Oh shit. I'll have to ride on the road here. Well, people are not gonna be used to it, seeing what I think is a bicycle on the road. So we'll see how it goes. There's the first car behind me. It's gonna overtake me now. understand that most drivers won't stick to the 60 kilometer limit here. It's a pretty wide and long road, not really busy. So yeah, but the bicycle path is too small. I think it's only 2 meters wide and it's two directions, so 1 meter per direction, and it should be 2 meters in each direction. And a 60 kilometer an hour road is the maximum speed type of road where a moped can ride, and so also a speed pedelec, and limit for mopeds and speed pedelecs is 45 kilometers an hour. So yeah, I was going way over 60 kilometers an hour. Well, people can easily drive twice my speed, so not always the nicest feeling. And if I would have a strong headwind, or if it was really busy here, I would just go on the bike path for safety. It's not according to the rules, but oh. Yeah, someone coming up fast behind. Thought of overtaking me, but he didn't make it, and I was pushing him. Not honking the horn yet. Okay, he's quite patient. That's nice. Come on. She shouted "Fietspad," so she doesn't know the rules. It's been over 6 years, but they just don't know the rules. That's a moped with a blue license plate. It can only go 25 kilometers an hour, so it's like a bicycle. It's not seen as a real moped. That's why it's on the bike path. Rustenburg. Cyclist was actually killed here by a truck yesterday. Okay, let's go back to Heergewaard. Just stay on the road for a long time. Long straight road again. A little bit busier, probably, because it's going to Heergewaard. Which next wall climb. By far the biggest place around. So far, so good. So that was 43 kilometers, 1 hour 26 minutes. There's a car behind me. This is het kruis, a neighborhood in Heerflaak. Used to be a small village of its own. That's a long time ago. This should be fun. Thank you. Well, that was it. 47 and a half kilometers, 1 hour and 34 minutes. Average of 30. Bye bye. Please like and subscribe.